I have just finished 12 weeks of hypertrophy, and I was supposed to be doing 24 weeks of hypertrophy, but I just cannot deal with hypertrophy training. I find it insanely boring, right? My ADHD does not allow me to perform moderate weight sets at higher volumes. I just get straight up bored, right? So I'm cutting it off.
Rip and tear until it is done.
I'm not gonna stick with hypertrophy as long as I thought I was going to. Instead, I need to move some stuff. I need to move some heavy weight. I need to be explosive. I need to feel athletic, right? I definitely managed to put on a decent amount of size over the last few months. And I'm still going to not just like focus on max lifting, but I need something more performance-based than what I was doing. It just doesn't keep my attention. And then I start sandbagging it and I'm just not built like that. I think a lot of people are. I think a lot of the reason why people end up not being consistent with fitness is mainly because everyone's so like focused on building muscle over absolutely everything, as though that's the only outcome we're after in the gym. And doing sets of 8 to 12 on various exercises over and over again, unless you're built that way, super boring. And I find it super boring. I need the training to be fun. I'm not an athlete. I'm not trying to compete in anything. So therefore the actual journey needs to be enjoyable. So what are my new goals then? This current training cycle that I've just begun, this is the first week, so there's a lot of calibrating still happening, is I wanna really front squat 200 kilograms. I don't know if that's possible. The most I've ever done is 180. I missed 190. And now I think I can do about 160. So that's gonna be one of my primary lifts. That is what I'm gonna focus my energy into making stronger. But alongside this, I'm also going to be focusing on getting more movement in, being more explosive, more athletic, because I don't like being sedentary. And I don't think that we should go to the gym to learn to move slowly. I think we should go to the gym to learn to move dangerously, right? So if life ever calls for it, you have the capabilities of doing so. Another thing is, people that are drawn to strength training are often naturally quite explosive, right? Like that's what makes you more gifted towards strength training when you're an explosive person. Some people are just like brute strength and they can grind stuff out, but most of us smaller guys, it's generally because we're explosive. And as you get older, your ability to stay explosive definitely drops off. That's why there's no old Olympic lifters. So therefore, I think if explosiveness comes naturally when you're young, you've got to keep nurturing it as you get older. Otherwise, you're going to lose it and things just kind of fall apart more rapidly once you lose this ability that you once relied on in order to be strong. So today we're going to be doing a bunch of post-activation potentiation, PAP training, or fringe contrast training, which is basically the pairing of like a heavy explosive movement with a lighter explosive movement. So for instance, the first thing I'm going to do is like a relatively heavy, relatively like 80% barbell clean into a hang clean. Then I'm going to put that down and then I'm going to do a weighted seated box jump. You keep the reps low. So we've got 5 rounds of 3 reps superset. And this is just kind of what it looks like. Yeah. It's weird because most people on YouTube know me as a kettlebell guy. Let me turn this music off. It's weird because most of my audience I've built on YouTube is from the kettlebell stuff, and I'm not actually a kettlebell guy. I'm a move heavy barbells and odd objects as much as I can. The kettlebells is quite a break away from where how I normally train. So with the PAP training, we've now got an explosive plyometric. I'm doing a weighted box jump. They are like superset, but not in the traditional sense. You kind of do want some recovery between the super heavy movement and the explosive movement. So I'm going to set that up now and you can see that. So it's like five rounds moving between those two movements. You actually do take like 2 minutes off between. So like I said, not a super fast superset. And this is what I like to do, right? So like, don't go too heavy on any like weighted jumps. That's probably even a bit heavy for me, but I'm trying to not let my ego take over, but it's coming very close. But yeah, this is actually how I like to train. You know, like, I hate that term functional, but I guess it kind of is. Functional with less cardio.
For the next section of this workout, we're sticking with a similar protocol to before, except this time we're taking a 60 kg sandbag and we're going for 3 lap to chest extensions, making sure that we're really getting as much extension through the hips before chucking it over that shoulder. We're then moving straight into these unwieldy kettlebell swings. Like, I'm waiting for the kettlebell guys to sound off in the comments and tell me I'm doing it wrong. But I don't really care about actual technique with the kettlebells for these. I'm just trying to be as explosive as I can. Just like, how much force can I use my hips to just drive that kettlebell as high as possible? Then finally, tipping it off with just a single box jump as high as possible for the day. It's been a while since I've jumped so high, and yeah, looking forward to getting much more used to going flying, I guess.
So that is that workout, done and dusted. Felt good to be moving explosively again. Good to see that I still can jump up stuff. And we're just gonna challenge ourselves over the next few weeks on getting more, moving quicker and quicker and quicker. And the point of this style of training is to actually move faster, not necessarily move more weight, but we will increase the weight because, again, I just get bored, right? Like, I can't just be like, oh, my velocity is slightly better. So I will definitely up the weight as we go. But the primary focus on today's training isn't moving weight. There is a day that is more heavy, lower body orientated, and those are the days I'm gonna use to work my way up to the 200 kg front squat. It wasn't really a point of this video. I just wanted to post something that isn't a long 30-minute video of me ranting about a topic. Just something a bit more raw and real. And yeah, just what some of my training looks like. So till next time, if you like the video, subscribe. If you like this kind of content, let me know. If you prefer the 30-minute videos in which I take too much caffeine and ADHD medicine and pretty much rant at a camera for half an hour, I can do those as well. Man of many talents. Till next time.